Thank you. Thanks a lot. And very sorry, I forget for the start to start the recording also. Here, you have noted the best points. And actually, I want to say to all of you that please share your thoughts also, like the Aparna ji, Rashmi ji, Divya ji, Nancy Sharma ji, Shraddha ji, and all participants. Please share your thoughts, your views about the museums as the material culture, because we want to know this concept from your side too. Because it will not become a one side, only the like the lectures. We all are the matured and post-graduated students or the researchers or the professors. So we need to share our views regarding this. संग्रहालय में वस्तु जो हम रखते हैं, जो भी चीजें रखते हैं, उसके बारे में आप क्या सोचते हैं? नैन्सी शर्मा जी, यस प्लीज।
Good morning, everyone.
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
Museum for me is like a soul of our society. Like it represents a unique tradition or the unique ideas the past have, the past people have. It's like a bridge between the past, present, and the future. And it connects all that things. And so for me, museum give me inspiration to do something great. Like how the past people have created such unique ideas, such unique things that I'm totally inspired by that. And really, museum give me energy to do something different that stands out. So for me,
Yes,
museum is like energy booster. Thank you, sir.
thank you, thank you. As you mentioned here, the museums are like as the soul of our society. Then, if we quote this sentence, and if we start a mission with this statement, "Museums are soul of our society," then how you want to represent your soul? How you want to represent your museum in front of the all of the world, or the in front of the scholars, or those from the other societies? So like that, just I want to say, it means that we need the best museums. We need the museums which say the uniqueness of your area like that. So thank you, Nancy ji. And anyone else? Anyone else? Yes, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I'm given my anthropology background. Material culture is part of our early years, and then how we understand a culture from the material point of view. So we used to collect when we go for field work from the indigenous community, kind of what kind of artifacts they use for hunting, and then everyday usage and what they are producing locally. So all that. Whatever the ethnographic or participant observation can tell you, the materials give you equal an amount of information when you study about, collect and study about the material and then interact with the community. I'm talking about the contemporary things. The same way, the artifacts which is collected from the excavations and then from other sites also play a major role to understand and fill the gap of how the society has functioned. So that way, material culture has to be given enough importance, and the museums play a major role in safeguarding and preserving such kind of material to tell the future generation how our predecessors or the past generation have lived their life and how we have improved, or is there anything else we have to learn from a past society. So that way, both museum and material culture play a major role in this. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Thanks a lot, sir. As you mentioned, from your this argument, fill the gap. This is an important thing. Fill the gap and learn from the past. So in our history also, we use this statement, learn from the past. Actually, it's too much needed nowadays, because what we learn from our past? So this is a question mark. If we can solve this through our museums, it will be too good. And fill the gap. Now, at present, this is most needful in this virtual world, the fill the gap. So how we can fill this gap, we'll study about it too. Please note these all points by the scholars, those who are present their own these aspects. So please note the points so that it will be useful to you in future too. As yesterday, I was sent a post in our WhatsApp group. One of my book, Encyclopedia of Indian Heritage, which published yesterday only. In that book also, I mentioned these our heritage sites as open air museums. Many times I used this term. Why so? Because we need to fill the gap. So we will study about that too. Anyone else want to share something?
Sir, I'm Sharda here. Yes. Good morning.
Yes, very good morning.
What we understand as museum,
you lost your voice. Yes, now please say once again. We can't hear you properly.
Sir, can you hear me now?
Yes, now it's okay.
Yeah, so the point I was trying to make was that like what we understand is museums are just 400, 500 years. If you look at the oldest, it would be 17th century or 16th century. But in our country, temples, all our ancient temples also acted as museums. So they also were, you know, they also had this conveyed this message of inspiration to do something great. These also acted as the souls of our society, and they captured the essence of the society. For example, if you look at Hoysala temples, Halebid, Belur temples, which were built 800, 900 years back, many of these temples, they captured the fashions of those days, you know, the types of dresses worn by the people, and also even the hairstyles were captured, and the kind of ornaments. I mean, just giving one example of a temple, but I'm sure like there we can find many such examples where temples also played the role of museum. So it was not just for one particular either a spiritual purpose. It was also meant for it also acted as a you know, to capture the material culture, the essence of the society.
Yes, thank you. As you mentioned about when Hoysala architecture or about the Belur, in one campus there are the 19 temples are there in Belur, and in Halebid, just in front of the bus stand, there Hoysaleshwara temple, and at the right side, a half an kilometer after, two Jain temples are there, and then after one more temple. So these all temples or any such type of the historical monuments, which are becomes the traditional knowledge systems, the art practices of our ancient and medieval India like that. So we need to study these all things. And as Divya Seniji mentioned here in our chat box, whatever we heard and study can be very fruitful with museum visits. It helps in clear understanding of the subject. So whatever we are students or scholars or general public, museums are very enriching for all to understand our society and the past. But we need here to say about the material culture. So we will start here our session. Anyone else want to share his or her aspect? Binduji or Minuji, Kavyaji, Surmayaji, anyone? Oini? Or Mushaida ji, anyone else who want to? Rakesh ji.
Namaste, sir. Bindu Subramani here. I think recording and archiving the past in whichever form it is, whether it is in stone or whether it is in a museum, in temple, anywhere, actually this is very important. One is we have to learn what they have been doing in the past, learn all the good things, but also, you know, it is also to learn, that not to repeat the mistakes that they have done maybe. You know, there are so many things that we can actually learn from them. I'm sure there are many things that we have still not discovered, which is still waiting for us to understand. We'll have to know it in a better, in that form, you know, so that, you know, we can learn from it. There's so much to learn. It is like an entire treasure trove, actually. The way we look at it is more important.
Yes, thank you. And as you mentioned that we need to avoid the mistakes in the past. And the second thing you mentioned, we need to discover so many things. So this is the human tendency to find out or to in search of something new. So like that. But please be note that whatever we have with us at present also, if we will follow it properly, हमारे पास आज जो कुछ भी है, जो भी नॉलेज है, जो भी कुदरत हमारे पास है, अगर हम उसको भी प्रॉपर रूप से केयर करते हुए विथ लव टू ईच अदर प्रॉपरली एंड द हार्मनी बिटवीन द ह्यूमन एंड द नेचर, इफ वी फॉलो दिस पाथ रियली वी विल एंजॉय दिस एंटायर वर्ल्ड बट द नीड इज टू अंडरस्टैंड इट प्रॉपरली सो नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट अवर सेशन हियर यस यू वांट टू से समथिंग बिंदु जी
No, we need to respect the past. That is the most important thing.
Yes, yes, very true, very true. Thank you, thank you. Now we'll start our session. I will start my presentation here. Just a minute. Please keep your pen and notebook with you so that you can enjoy few points here. So as our today's topic is there, analytic or object-based museum approach as the material culture. So can you see this beautiful picture, a little child who enjoyed this museum with learning in the museum. So here, in general aspect, a picture in our mind, the museum is like this. There are the some vertical showcases, some horizontal showcases, some of the display panels or something else. But like this, this is a general view of any museum as per our this today's world, this present world. But just I want to say that, is museum means only a collection? If yes, then please enjoy it. Please enjoy it. Just I want to say, you never think about that. Which techniques or which modern technologies or how best it is, which type of maintenance is there, is it really too good, the beautiful showcases like that. Please forget about these all things. You just enjoy the collection as we enjoy this collection in our childhood. हमने अपने बचपन में इस तरह की कई सारी चीजों को collect किया था. We collected lot of things in our museums, okay, and we enjoyed that. So this is my personal collection. I have two such notebooks, big notebooks, in which I collected this matchbox. And till today, there are a lot of matchbox to paste in notebooks. But now I stopped it because I want to share this my happiness with the new generations. So now I'm trying to share it. If I have more than 4 or 5 matchbox or more than 2 also, I always used to share it with others, and they also share it with me. So like this matchbox, the coins or the postcards or philately collection like that. So up to now, I have collected more than thousands, 3,000 of different types of matchboxes and around 22,000 of postal stamps. So like that, we want to just share our happiness with others. Please note this point. We want to share just our happiness with others through these collections, through these materials. Okay, please note this point. Then here you can see these are the varieties or the different types of the clocks. You can see this in our shops, this old shops. Aaj bhi kuch dukano mein is tarah ki jo hai wall clocks hame dikhai deti hai. What is this? Is it a collection? और इज इट अ म्यूजियम? नो, इट्स अ शॉप. एक दुकान है जिस दुकान में ये रखी गई है, पुरानी घड़ियां रखी गई है. ये फोटोग्राफ एक पुराने दुकान से लिया गया था और ये उसका अपना रोजी रोटी चलाता है. ओके, सो द हैप्पीनेस एंड नाउ वी मूव टुवर्ड्स द हिज ब्रेड एंड बटर फ्रॉम दिस कलेक्शन. ओके, देन द थर्ड थिंग इज देयर हियर इज अ इंस्टीट्यूशन. This is the museum. So in this museum, you can see here the objects, the material, whatever be there in the museum, the sculptures or some other artifacts like that. But can we say it is proper as per our museum terminology? Not yet. But till then, we can enjoy this a lot because we want to study the sculptures. We want to study these statues, and we want to note our this past. I just many of our scholars mentioned regarding we want to learn from the past. So we want to study the art, the architecture, or whatever be the best practices, the knowledge from our past. Okay, now here you can see it's a beautiful we can say the collection, or they display it by proper ways, but again we think over this, is there any information panels are here, any information stickers or like that, any small display boards regarding the information, is it there anything? No, but till then it's a good collection, so we enjoyed this as a collection. Okay, then here this is a modern techniques of the museums, modern collections we can say, art galleries like that, but till then is there any information board here? No, but again I want to say we enjoyed this. How can we enjoy then here in our matches box? We can enjoy without any knowledge we can enjoy the match box. But here in this modern art, or we can see this, mujhe abhi ye particular term pata nahi hai, ye jo painting, sorry, ye jo chitra paintings yahan par jo banaya hai, jise aadhunik stam shaili jisko kahi jati hai, amurt chitra shaili, so this word used there, amurt chitra shaili. So chitra kya hai ye aapko samajhna hai, what is the painting, you need to understood it. But generally whenever I visited such type of the museums, I can't enjoy that because I haven't any knowledge about that. So we need a proper knowledge to enjoy these artifacts. So here please note again that after you have the knowledge, you have the little bit knowledge regarding that objects or the artifacts, you can enjoy that. So like that. Now here see these, all these statues, as we know, these are just kept in the museum when the new art gallery was opened. At that time just kept these all statues here without any information or like that anything, but till then we enjoyed. What's here, what's the beauty here, you can see the statues and its art, but till again one more thing is here, what is there, the color combinations, the background and the front side view or like that. So this material culture with its surrounding, material culture with its surrounding. Okay, then again here you can see in this museum, here there are the few paintings in a museum, a famous museum is there, till there is no any information or kuch bhi wahan par stickers nahi lagaye hai ki ye painting kaun se period ka hai, kiska hai, kisne banaya, who is the artist, like that. There is no any information with these paintings, but till then we can enjoy it. How it's depend on us. So like that, you can see this is actually a historic building, a historic monument building, a historic museum, and in that museum these paintings are there. These all are the gold paintings, maximum paintings are the gold paintings, and here this epic stories also there in this museum panels. Now here we can see the, as per this modern terminology, here we can see this first photograph inside a museum. As we know, this is now in Smithsonian museum, it says of 16th century photograph like that, and we know about this because in our first or second session we discussed about it. So what is here, there is something which kept properly with segregate sets. जैसे हम कहते कलेक्शन किया है, मगर कलेक्शन में उसका कैटेगरी बनाए हैं और उसके हिसाब से इसको लगाया गया है. जस्ट दे केप्ट, जैसे हम मेडिकल में जाते हैं तो टैबलेट्स किस तरफ में है, या फिर ये दवाई की बॉटल्स किस तरफ रखी हुई है, उसका एक प्रॉपर सेग्रीगेशन होता है. और इन आवर किराना ग्रोसरी शॉप्स आल्सो वी कैन सी ऑल द सोप्स आर वन एट वन साइड, आर द पेंस आर एनी अदर ऑब्जेक्ट्स लाइक दैट, दे केप्ट on the proper places like that. So we need here the objects with its proper places. Okay, the bifurcation of the collections with the item wise. Now we move towards here, museums of early 19th century were primarily used to showcase the power and wealth of government of countries that engaged in the business of imperialism. In our third session, we discussed about this in our session of history of museums. In that, the museum displayed imperial conquest, exhibited the exotic material treasures brought back to Europe by colonial administrators. And till today, this system continued there in this European countries, or we can say in other countries too. So Wittgenstein supports this assertion by him stating that the Museum of Napoleon at the Louvre displayed the beauty of imperial conquest. Every new campaign necessitated opening a new gallery to house the material shipped to Paris after the battles. So now just I want to say one thing here with these objects, the new gallery to house the material shipped to Paris after the battles. So for the French nation, for the France, this collection may be it's their imperial or this we can say the prestige point, but for other countries, what's it? हम जब संग्रहालय में चीजों को देखते हैं, तो जब जब किसी ने किसी राष्ट्र से ये चीजें उठा के लेके आए हैं, युद्ध में जीतने के बाद वो लेकर आए हैं, तो संग्रहालय में चीजें रखी हुई है, वो उनके लिए अपना राष्ट्रवाद, नेशनलिज्म, और वी कैन से हमने कैसे जीता है दूसरों को, उसका एक प्रतीकात्मक हो गया, द विन सिचुएशन, वी कैन से हमने हम जीते हैं, विक्ट्री, तो आप जीता की दृष्टि से उसकी तरफ देख रहे हैं. But at the same time, what will be the aspect for the others, the same objects in the in your museum? जैसे अगर हमारे भारत से मयूर सिंहासन या फिर जो हमारा कोहिनूर डायमंड हम कहीं किसी पैलेस में, कहीं बेकिंघम पैलेस और किसी म्यूजियम में जब देखते हैं, तो आपको क्या फील होता है? उनके लिए तो वो एक प्रतिष्ठा, प्रेस्टीज पॉइंट लगता होगा, बट हाउ यू कैन फील एज अ इंडियन? सो लाइक दैट वी नीड टू थिंक ऑल दिस ऑब्जेक्ट्स. ओके, सो व्हाट आई वांट टू से, आई विल एक्सप्लेन फर्दर. बाय द लैटर हाफ ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन वॉज ऑन द इंक्रीज, पुशिंग पॉपुलेशन टू द सिटीज. गवर्नमेंट्स ऑल्सो बिकम मोर अवेयर ऑफ दियर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज for social services and educations. So museums were seen as one of the institutions for the education of the masses. Education of the masses, okay? It was equally perceived that museums could help people appreciate the value of modern life. Museum exhibitions, for instance, were used to lend support to public campaigns for health education, to demonstrate achievement in science and technology, and as entertainment for people. So as one of our scholar mentioned regarding this, the achievements in science and technology, again the word important is here, entertainment for people. Then now what happened everywhere in the museums, people they traveled through the museums, but what the aspect there, as the watching as only to enjoy few of the objects, but here the last word, entertainment for people. The museums established for the entertainment of people, and it's just the exhibition of the objects, but nowadays this is the responsibility of the government and the museum professionals. We need to understood it's the learning process through the entertainment, learning process through the enjoyment. So note this point here for the museum. So we need such types. If you have, if it's possible, then the material culture, the for the education through the entertainment. Okay, when one thinks about the kinds of learning that can go on in museums, two characteristics unique to such institutions must be kept in mind. First, the museum's primary teaching tool is a superior set of stimuli. The primary aim of museum education must be to bring together people and objects. See, to bring together people and objects. Just I want to give an example to you. Not people and information about objects. Okay, just I want to give an example. If you stand on a square in your street, in your city. And if you just announce or you just say the people that such and such information I have about this thing or like that, what will happen? Few of the people will come towards you and they will learn, they will listen to you. But at the same time, if you have that object with you, what will happen? जरा एक बार कोशिश करके देखिए कि आपके शहर के चौराहे पर खड़े रहिए और लोगों को चिल्ला चिल्ला कर ये बोलिए कि भाइयों मेरे पास ऐसे ऐसे एक डायमंड के बारे में या फिर मेरे पास एक ऐसे बहुत पुराने एक मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन है या फिर किसी ऐसे एक गोल्डन बॉक्स के बारे में कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन है. क्या होगा? कुछ लोग आएंगे सुनेंगे. बट अगर आपके पास वो ऑब्जेक्ट होगा और वो अगर आप लोगों को दिखाएंगे और बोलेंगे तो वही भीड़ ज्यादा होगी. Why it so? ये क्यों? इसका कारण क्या है? So you note this point. The primary aim of museum education must be to bring together people and objects, not people and information about objects. So note this. Programs which deal essentially in information about an artist's life or painting techniques are peripheral to the essential experience of the visitor, that of seeing, reacting to, and thinking about a museum art object. Again, you note down that if you have the object, but if you haven't any proper information about the object, what will happen? If you just kept the objects in your museum, if your museum is just a collection of the objects, what will happen? Those who have the knowledge regarding that object, they will enjoy it. But those who haven't any idea, who haven't any such type of the knowledge about that artifacts or the object, what will happen? They just travel there only. वो सिर्फ इधर से उधर घूमेंगे मगर उसको एंजॉय नहीं कर पाएंगे. सो वी नीड दिस फॉर द पेरिफेरल टू द एसेंशियल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द विजिटर. ओके, देयर इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड वाइबल रोल फॉर सच पेरिफेरल इंफॉर्मेशन एज एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू एक्सपीरियंसेस. सो दिस इज अ वेरी कीन प्रोसेस. जब आप संग्रहालय में ऑब्जेक्ट्स की जो लोगों को जानकारी देते हैं, जानकारी इंट्रोडक्शन और एक्सपीरियंस करवाना चाहते हैं, तो आपको बहुत सोचना पड़ता है. दिस इज डिपेंड ऑन योर एक्सपर्टीज इन दैट म्यूजियम आर्टिफैक्ट्स. आर यू अ हिस्टोरियन? आर यू अ कंजर्वेटर? और व्हाट एवर बी देयर यू आर. सो वी नीड टू कलेक्ट द प्रॉपर इंफॉर्मेशन विथ इट्स रोमांस. कुछ रोमांटिक लगना चाहिए, कुछ हटके अनुभव होना चाहिए. अगर कुछ साइंटिफिक ऑब्जेक्ट्स है तो उसका यूज कैसे किया जाता है साइंटिफिक टेक्नोलॉजी और इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इक्विपमेंट्स अगर आपके पास है तो उसका एक्सपीरियंस लोगों को होना चाहिए. इफ यू विजिट द सर्वेश्वरय्या इंडस्ट्रियल म्यूजियम देर आर लॉट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स बट few of them only they kept in their displays. Why? Because they want to give the experience of that electronic equipments or the devices, how we can use it. So this experiences with objects is most important. An introduction directed toward enhancing the visitor's experience of the object and making it more intense and meaningful. So here this thing is important. The second unique characteristic of museums is that, in contrast to schools, the other major learning environment in our culture, museums are non-directive educators. It's not directly associated, but non-directive educators, and the visitors is there by choice. Just I want to give an example here, potential learner. Please keep mute yourself. Yes, thank you, Aparna ji. Okay, if you want to ask anything, then please note your question in our chat box. Please write the question in chat box, so we'll discuss it at last. Okay. Yes. Okay. Then here, just I want to give an example there. In our Maharashtra state, our education secretary, he established one group there. It's ATS, Active Teachers, ATF Forum, Active Teachers Forum. In that group, only two persons. One is our MKCL, CDAC Computers Company Director, Dr. Vivek Savan, and I am also the member of that group. Why they want to keep this me and Savanji in that group? Because nowadays this movement started everywhere. The combination of the museums and the schools or the educational institutes and the experts of them, if we kept together, we both can learn from each other. So here, when the museums want to become as the educational organizations or the educational institute like that, and if the educational institutes want to make themselves as the best education facilitator or the experiencing this education, then they use the museums. So is there by choice? If visitors are to be pleased and satisfied, it is essential objects, and that museums offers a variety of ways of introducing audiences to their collections. Is this facility available in your museums, in your surrounding museums? That museums offer a variety of ways of introducing audience. So is it possible really in the museums nowadays? Yes, it's possible, but till today it's not in practices. Program should vary in length, in type, performing arts, lectures, label, audio visuals like that. Somewhere in the museums, a visitor can enjoy it half an hour. Somewhere it's in one hour, same gallery or same museum for half an hour or for 3 hours or more than that, like that. Because as I was visited Salar Jung Museum, I noticed that some of the people, they usually spend 1 hour to 1.5 hours. It's a general or the maximum people used to visit or spend this much time, 1 to 1.5 hours. But some of the students or the teachers, professors, those who want to study, they usually spend 3 to 4 hours there. But some of the more interested scholars, they spend more than one day, or they stayed somewhere in city, and again and again they usually visit for a week, for a month, like that. So if anyone want to study about the manuscripts, then particular that manuscript gallery, which are more than 150 manuscripts exhibited there, and in their collection they have more than 13,000 of manuscripts, so they want to study there. So like that, what is here, the variety of ways of introducing audiences to their collections. So program should be vary in length like that, and you can use the audio visual techniques there, and in levels of the sophistications like that. All program should, however, respect the visitor's personal experience. All program should respect visitor's personal experience. We need to really respect these things, keeping in mind the importance of objects and of the individual's right to his or her own experience of objects. The best goal for museum education programs is to help visitors to have personally significant experiences with art objects. The key words in this phrase are significant and with museum or art objects like that. The museum existence depends on the community's belief in the significance of the paintings, sculptures, ceramics, costumes, and other objects which it collects. Now, just I want to mention regarding one controversial issue or a controversial point here. If you just want to keep painting of Ramayana there, like the Dashara, nowadays you know about this. Jab Ravan ko jalaya jata hai, तो रावण को जलाए जाने का ये जो ये है, या फिर रावण वध की जो बात है, या फिर महिषासुर वध की जो बात है, दीज आर द स्टोरीज फ्रॉम आवर एपिक्स. बट इफ यू वांट टू कीप दिस पेंटिंग इन योर म्यूजियम, व्हाट विल हैपन इफ दैट कम्युनिटी हैव द बिलीव्स और दे आर एसोसिएटेड विद द महिषासुरा, व्हाट विल हैपन देयर? यू नो बेस्ट अबाउट दिस. सो यू नीड टू अवॉइड दैट कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल इश्यूज इन योर म्यूजियम. So it depends on the community's belief in the significance of the paintings, sculptures, ceramics, or whatever be there. Helping people have significant personal encounters with art objects is the most direct means of building such community support. We need it always. When people compare going to the zoo or a push button science museum with going to an art museum, they often complain, but what's there to do at the art museum? Usually it happened. क्योंकि कई बार जब मैं बेंगलोर विजिट करता हूँ तो बेंगलोर में जब मैं अपने फैमिली या जो भी फ्रेंड्स होते हैं उनके छोटे बच्चे जो होते हैं जब उनको आर्ट म्यूजियम में लेके जाना चाहता हूँ तो बहुत बार उनके फैमिलीज उनके जो मेरे फ्रेंड्स है वो पूछते हैं, दे आस्क यूजुअली टू मी व्हाट देयर टू डू द आर्ट म्यूजियम, वहां पे कई सारे पेंटिंग्स, इट्स ओके बट वी कांट एंजॉय इट देयर सो लाइक दैट. जैसे मैंने कहा था अमूर्त चित्र शैली के बारे में, आई हैवंट एनी सच आइडिया अबाउट दैट आर्ट, सो हाउ कैन वी एंजॉय. Now, this is the responsibility of the museum authorities, how we can make it interest. So this kind of question reflects a doubt that there is anything personally involving or significant that can occur when encountering art objects. It also reflects contemporary association of physical activity, doing something with involvement. How can we will see that some examples. The involvement possible in encounters with art objects is of an contemplative nature. The activity possible in such encounters is of an interior nature involving not physical but mental and emotional activity. We can say it as interactive museum or like that. We need the interaction of the peoples or the visitors with the objects, in museum objects. So here, just you can see, sorry, here principal secretary, Nitin Karirji, when he visited our museum, when I was explained in our museum, this famous painting by Vasudev Kamatji, he was too much, he becomes so emotional because when I was explained this painting, why we need such things today. Because nowadays we need bread and butter. सभी को दो वक्त की रोटी तो कम से कम मिलनी चाहिए. तो उसके लिए हम कैसे हमारे विलेज इंडस्ट्रीज को, हमारी ग्राम उद्योग को हम कैसे प्रोत्साहित कर सकते हैं. तो ये जब मैंने इस पेंटिंग से जुड़कर के उनसे बात की तो उनको बहुत अच्छा लगा, वो इमोशनल हो गए क्योंकि वो लाइफ उन्होंने एक्सपीरियंस किया है. एक वक्त की रोटी भी जब खाने को नहीं मिलती है, भूखा सोना पड़ता है कई दिनों तक, उस समय में काम की आवश्यकता क्या है, रोटी की आवश्यकता क्या है. व्हेन यू कनेक्ट सच थिंग्स विथ योर दिस कंटेम्पररी और वी कैन से द प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन, इट विल बी टू ब्यूटिफुल विथ द म्यूजियम ऑब्जेक्ट्स. देन here our major general, sorry, this is Lieutenant General Raju Edwards, when he visited the museum, he just asked me one question. I am a military person or I am an army man, then why I have to visit the Gandhi museum? Because Gandhi, it means a symbol of non-violence or like that. I just told him that just please enter the museum, get experience in one or two galleries. If you want, then you can visit further or you can left the museum. Then he spent nearly 3.5 hours in our museum. So like that. So why I want to say here, I used one line there. The person who always lived with the guns, the bullets and these all weapons, actually only the person, he can understood the importance of non-violence. जो रात दिन बंदूकों में और गोलियों के बौछारों में अपना जीवन गुजर रहा है, शांति का महत्व, अहिंसा का महत्व उस आदमी से बेहतर कौन जान सकता है. सो उनको बहुत अच्छा लगा और उन्होंने जब विजिट किया, एंड आवर म्यूजियम विच स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम आवर लाइफस्टाइल, आवर टुडेज लाइफस्टाइल, एंड देन इट नैरेट द स्टोरी ऑफ गांधी एंड लाइक दैट, एंड देन एट लास्ट हाउ वी कैन कनेक्ट इट विथ आवर दिस एंटायर टुडेज वर्ल्ड. Like that, the relevance of the museum. So we need to explain our museum objects like this way, so it will be useful for all. So here now again, you can see here, this is the Major General Rajesh Kundraji. He visited there and he also published my books there. When he visited, I just told him that if a pinch of salt become a symbol of revolution, ek mutthi bhar namak agar satyagraha ki ek badi taakat ban sakta hai, then why we not think over about this for to move this our entire society towards the best practices. हमारी देश में जैसे अभी हमारे एक मैडम ने जो बताया, our one scholar शारदा जी एंड some other, जिन्होंने बताया कि हमारे देश में ऐसी कई चीजें हैं, अवर टेम्पल्स आर सम ऑफ द मोर ब्यूटीफुल सच प्लेसेस, कि जो हमारी बेस्ट आर्ट प्रैक्टिसेस के एग्जांपल्स है. सो व्हाई वी कांट यूज दीज थिंग्स टू मूव दिस आवर सोसाइटी टूवर्ड्स दैट बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस. हमारे बच्चों को हम उस तरफ में क्यों नहीं लेके जा सकते. सो हाउ यू कैन यूज दिस योर म्यूजियम आर्ट ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर द म्यूजियम ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर वट एवर बी देयर इन योर म्यूजियम्स, how you can connect it with your society, it's important thing here. Now chief minister of Rajasthan Gehlot ji visited the museum and our department also. I was explained one of our museum activity, and the same activity he started in 2018 in Rajasthan state, and that year only 13 lakh students from Rajasthan they involve in that activity. Sorry, we are 12 and half lakh students participated in that activity. So what is this activity? We started by a museum. We started it in 2007 and we ran it up to 2018. Annually, around 4.5 lakh students participated in that activity. But only because of the chief minister visit and we properly explained that activity in front of him, then he got the seriousness of that museum activity and he started it in Rajasthan, and at the same year 12.5 lakh students participated. So what does now last year 23 lakh students participated in that activity. So we enjoyed this and we needed to spread the things or whatever you want, your aims and objects of the museum, you can spread in the society with using such movements. आप ऐसे क्षणों का we can say these are the golden opportunities. तो आपको जब ये मौका मिलता है उस मौके का आप जो है कैसा यूज करते हैं इस पर ये डिपेंड करेगा. Now here when our विद्यासागर राव सर द गवर्नर ऑफ महाराष्ट्र स्टेट when he visited here, this is the second last gallery of our museum. This is what the we can say this village Swaraj, Gram Swaraj. And here we explained about our villages, the rural developments. And from that year, from the year 2018, in our museum, every year annually, around 25 batches of these Panchayat Raj officers, government officers training started in our museum. And the program usually 8 days for a batch, and like that, around 25 batches every year. So what I want to say here, the objects, whatever be there in your museum, how you explained it, how people enjoy it, how people can learn through that object is the most important. Just we not need a show there only. Sirf ek show nahi banana hai, it must become a public movement. So we need such type of the material culture by this way only. So for effective children learning in museums, museum officials should ensure the availability of children friendly environment with the material culture. We need this children friendly environment which will enhance their physical and mental alertness for the learning session. Somewhere in our museums, very sorry to say that in my museums also, in the first stage we just put one board there, below the 5 age 5 साल से कम उम्र के बच्चे जो है उनको माता पिता जो है अपने पास ही संभाल के रखे और उनको जो है म्यूजियम में कोई ऑडियो गाइड और ये नहीं ऑडियो पोर्ट वगैरह नहीं दिया जाएगा. बट आफ्टर माय 8 इयर्स एक्सपीरियंस इन दिस फील्ड पर्टिकुलरली रिगार्डिंग दिस टॉपिक, मैंने ये अनुभव किया है कि 5 साल से कम उम्र का बच्चा भी जो है जब उसको ऑडियो पोर्ट लगाया जाता है, उसके कान को हेडफोन लगाया जाता है और उसको जो समझे, उसको जिसका अट्रैक्शन हो, ऐसे इसमें अगर हम अपना जो कंटेंट है उसको अगर डेवलप करते हैं, यूजुअली दे केयरफुली ऑब्जर्व दैट आवर ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो इट्स एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग आफ्टर नियरली 6.5 लाख हमने 6.5 लाख बच्चे और उनके फैमिली जो हमारे यहाँ पर विजिट किए उनके साथ एक्सपेरिमेंट करने के बाद हमने ये महसूस किया. सो आई वॉन्ट टू से हियर the we should ensure the availability of children friendly environment. Whenever the playgroup students or the nursery school students visited our museum, we need that way. We need to serious college aur inke bachchon ke liye main easily museum design kar paunga, but when we want to establish a museum for the these primary school students, for specifically nursery school students. We need to take so much care regarding that, and which will ensure their physical and mental alertness for the learning session. And then this is particularly necessary for preschool children. During museum visits, people accompanied by their teachers are presented with the opportunity of handling and exploring museum exhibits. Is it possible to nowadays in our museums, are they really can handle the objects? You can keep there the replicas of the objects. आप रख सकते हैं आपके संग्रहालय में ऐसी replicas रख सकते हैं. If not possible the original artifacts, why we need so? Because they will enjoy, and from that enjoy they will get the knowledge, and from that knowledge they will properly care that object, so they will value it. So like that, this is a cycle. As we know, it is a heritage cycle. By exploring material culture, people can learn about object and its relationship to other objects, eras, cultures and people. So in this method of learning, people interact with museum exhibits. The unique tangibility of these artifacts can motivate curiosity among children, with questions people discover the role of these objects and their relevance to past and present times. So by this way of the material culture, we can solve these all things. So here now again, you can see here the museum education, an effort to ignite the young minds to appreciate artworks using the department museum as tool and resource, an exciting experience. Now you can see here an example of our this MSU, Maharaja Sayajirao Gaikwad University, Baroda. Dr. Ambika Patel ji here, nowadays she is working as the head of the department, and also she's an working as the president of International Council of Museums for India. But see how she enjoyed here, and how the students also enjoyed here in the museum. So to appreciate artworks using our these museums as tool and resource, an exciting experiment to aggregate young minds. Now here one another example you can see in museum. Is there really such a place can we channelize our these tools? अगर हमें स्कूल स्टूडेंट अगर हमारे संग्रहालय को विजिट करने वाले हैं, अगर उनके टीचर्स के साथ अगर हमारा प्रॉपर डायलॉग हो जाता है, वो अगर ठीक से समय देना चाहते हैं, then we can organize such type of tours where only that school visit in that 3 hours or whatever be there, 1 hour or like that, or 2 hours like that, and we can interact with the students very easily. आराम से उनको बिठा करके हम उनके साथ डिस्कस कर सकते हैं, एक एक ऑब्जेक्ट की प्रॉपर रूप से इंफॉर्मेशन दे करके उनमें ये, और क्यूरियोसिटी, बच्चों में बहुत क्यूरियोसिटी रहती है, सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस इन देयर माइंड्स, दे आस्क्ड अस, सो वी यूज दिस ऑब्जेक्ट्स फॉर टू इंक्रीज दिस क्यूरियोसिटी अगेन. आप उनको ये भी बताएं संग्रहालय में इतनी चीजें हैं, बट इट्स नॉट सफिशियंट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो मोर you need to visit so and so places so that you will get the more knowledge, you can read such and such book so that you will get the more knowledge. So like that, we need to arrange such type of tours in our museums. Here you can see very keenly and properly when students visited and watch this all the objects and they studied it properly. But before of that, we need to give information, pamphlets or the brochures or the proper information to them, how we can visit this museum, what are the best things in this museum. So like that, then the student will become serious. But usually this will not happen in our museum. So just they enter and they get out from the museum. So learning is the process of acquiring knowledge and skills, modifying and strengthening existing knowledge through study, practice, experience and teaching. Learning is a main aim of education. There are various ways of learning. सीखने की कई सारे तरीके हैं. Audio visual, visual learning by listening and speaking, learning by feeling and touching, learning from experience, learning through the intellect and object based learning. And these all can possible in our museum. ये सभी बातें हमारे संग्रहालय में सहज रूप से हम कर सकते हैं. So these all types of learnings, these all types of this educations, these methods, we can adopt in our museum. So museum education, whether intramural or extramural, is always characterized by the use of objects in the learning process. Indeed, a hallmark of museum education is the opportunity to learn from objects. The basis of using objects in learning is to break educational content into small chunks that can be reused in various learning environments. Each learning object can be taken independently. Therefore, learning objects are self-contained. Just I want to give an example again here. If you have a sword with you, what will you say your students? आपके संग्रहालय में समझ लीजिए एक तलवार आपके पास है, एक बेस्ट सोर्ड आपके पास है, आप क्या जानकारी देंगे बच्चों को? यू कैन से हियर द इट कंटेंट इन टू स्मॉल चंक्स एंड दैट कैन बी रीयूज्ड इन वेरियस लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट्स. हाउ कैन, जस्ट आई वांट टू एक्सप्लेन हियर. जब आपके पास कोई बेस्ट तलवार है तब आप उनको ये बताएं कि उस समय में ये तलवार किस राजा ने यूज की थी, उसके उस राजा के क्या गुण थे, उसने उस युद्ध को कैसे जीता, उसका टेक्निक्स क्या उसने यूज किया, लाइक दैट. देन द मेट्रोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दैट सोर्स, विच टाइप ऑफ टेक्निक्स दे यूज्ड हियर फॉर दैट सोर्ड, ये तलवार बनाने के लिए कौन सा मेटल यूज किया गया, उस मेटल उस तलवार कैसे ढाला गया, वो आर्ट प्रैक्टिसेस कैसी थी, उसको टेक्निकल प्रैक्टिसेस कैसी थी, वो आप बता सकेंगे. थर्ड थिंग इज दैट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दैट सोसाइटी. आप लोगों को उस समय का कल्चर क्या था, लोग क्या चाहते थे, भले ही युद्ध जीत लिया हो, जैसे सम्राट अशोक का एग्जाम्पल देते हैं, भले ही युद्ध जीत लिया हो मगर युद्ध में जो हानि हुई, जो हिंसा हुई, उसकी वजह से उसका पूरा माइंड सेटअप बदल गया और उसने पूरी तरह से जो है खुद को शांति, नॉन वायलेंस, पीस, लव, इसकी तरफ वो कैसे बढ़ा, वो आप वो से यू कैन नैरेट दीज स्टोरीज विथ यूजिंग द सेम ऑब्जेक्ट. सो वी नीड दीज थिंग्स. एंड फर्दर मोर, ऑब्जेक्ट बेस्ड लर्निंग अलाउज द यूज ऑफ फीलिंग एंड टचिंग इन द लर्निंग प्रोसेस. दिस ब्रिंग्स अबाउट एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग, अ फॉर्म ऑफ लर्निंग दैट कैन नॉट बी रिप्रोड्यूस्ड अदरवाइज. सो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. Kenneth Murie in 1927, he used around 93 years, 92 years back, made a collection of Nigerian works of art with the intention that art works could be used at teaching aids. So this is important. Till today, are we really using such type of the artworks as our teaching aids? This action exhibits the fact that he recognized the usefulness of objects in the learning process. Today, the use of instructional materials or teaching aids in schools is becoming popular. School authorities have realized the importance of using objects as teaching aids. So, museum is as learning laboratory. Now, here you note that, is there a laboratory of social sciences in our colleges nowadays? No. Only science laboratories are there. Till today, there is no any commerce subjects or the social sciences subjects laboratories are not there in our colleges or in our universities. But here, museum you can use as the learning laboratory is very relevant in this regard, because at present, learning in museums is object-based. So I used here this word, at present, learning in museums is object-based. Around in 95% museums. Nowadays, 5% museums are changed. How it, we will see that furthermore. Every object has a bunch of information surrounding it. Objects can engage people's attention, stimulate thought and reflection, arouse curiosity, and can be used to initiate discussion and make connection to people's experiences. Direct interaction with objects allows for visual and kinesthetic learning that can be far richer than text alone. So here, museum objects are not just objects. They are also the embodiment of aspects of people's culture. As now Purnar sir mentioned about that ethnographical study like that, such as the artistic ignuity of people, objects in museums are rare and unique. That is why museums are referred to as cabinet of curiosity, which word we studied in our last sessions. Museum objects are powerful learning materials. They can stimulate intense levels of wanting to know and can unleash strong emotions in people. The aim of this paper is to wrote an article for this Universal Research Analysis Research Journal is to discuss museum education with special reference to object-based learning measures. Now here, just one example you can see here. What is here? What is the collection? Just only the minerals, or we can say the gemstones like that. Here you can see these all are the natural objects. Okay, they all get from the nature. हम कुदरत से अलग अलग जगह विजिट करके ऐसे ऑब्जेक्ट्स को कलेक्ट कर सकते हैं. बट इज दिस ओनली द ब्यूटिफुल ऑब्जेक्ट्स? आर इज देयर आवर इंटेंशन टू कलेक्ट ओनली सच टाइप ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल आर्टिफैक्ट फ्रॉम द नेचर? नो, वी नीड टू शो दिस एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज, वी नीड टू शो द हार्मनी ऑफ द ह्यूमन एंड द नेचर, एंड देन यू कैन टीच मेनी सच थिंग्स फ्रॉम दिस आर्टिफैक्ट्स इन द म्यूजियम. So now this is the upcoming Argote Natural History Museum in Shirdi, which is a famous place in Maharashtra. And then this is the portion of Delhi, the Argote Museum in Delhi. Now it will be open. Then the International Council of Museums also defines the museum as the definition when we studied in our second session, which acquires, conserves, research, communicates and exhibits for purpose of study, education and enjoyment, material evidence of people. Material evidence of people and their environment. So such type of the things we need to study in our museums. You can see here some of the activities related to the museum objects or the replicas of the museum objects or the archaeological artifacts, and the how we can interact with the new generations with using such objects. You can see a few of the examples from our this Numismatic Museum of Engineering, Nashik also. There they organize such type of the courses with using simple clay. How can we make the artifacts like in the ancient period in Lothal museums or like that? But we need to give some of the best certificate to the students also for the attendance, though the visitors and the peoples are there. When they enjoyed and this type of the practical experiences in our museum. So if you will give them, it will be too beautiful. Now, when the peoples will not able to reach at museum, jab log sangrahalay tak nahi pahunch sakte hai, it's not possible to visit all the peoples to the museums, then we need to go towards the people. Tab hame logon ke paas tak jana hai. We need to visit the schools and colleges and like that. Here in our colleges, why it needs our traditional concepts kya thi hamari, ye hum unko bachchon ko batayenge schoolon mein, colleges mein ja kar ke hum is tarah se programs karenge, tab ja kar ke bachchon ko jo hai usme aur zyada ruchi nirman hogi. They will get more and more interest in our this artifacts, in the museum artifacts, and then with the using of this media, social media and all other medias, you use that, and then people will now, then you can put there when your notice board or like that any information. If you want to know more, please visit our museum. These all are the temporary exhibitions are like that. So you can put easily, simply the artifacts in front of them so that people can enjoy that. And then they visit the museums. Here you can see also, we use this science laboratory tables. See here, this is a chemistry laboratory. And we used that laboratory tables just there for the museums. And we exhibit some of the manuscripts and the coins and like that. This is what our mission, to involve these new generations in our this museum artifacts or in our history. So we need to exhibit such things here. And in the rural, remote village areas where there is nothing, you can see here, I just asked one खाट, हम इसको बेड कहते हैं जो हमारे रूरल एरियाज में यूज की जाती है, इसको मैंने घर से मांग लिया, उस किसान ने दे दिया, और वहीं के बच्चों को, आजू बाजू के बच्चों को हमने जमा करके उनके साथ में ये प्रोग्राम किया. दे एंजॉयड अ लॉट देयर. सो ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज वीक, यूजुअली आई वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज सच टाइप ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स, बिकॉज वी नीड टू रीच टूवर्ड्स द सोसाइटी. हमें लोगों तक जाना है, हमें लोगों तक पहुंचना है. लोग ही संग्रहालय की तरफ आए ये आवश्यक नहीं. सो यू कैन यूज दिस म्यूजियम मटेरियल और द मटेरियल कल्चर लाइक दिस वे. सो हियर अगेन अनदर so many such things I was mentioned here. Just as the example, Lothal Museum, 5,000 objects they have, but around 800 in display. But from that displays, what they want to show, the past and the present also. So here nowadays, such type of the modern museums are there. So they use different technologies and the techniques here, but it's not possible to all. But then also, we can fulfill our aims and objects with using this material culture. Now here you can see, this is something which is changed here. Are you get the knowledge? What's changed here actually? क्या बता सकते हैं कि यहाँ पर क्या चेंज हुआ है, कि ये एक्चुअली क्या है, क्या कोई बता सकता है? अगर बता सकते हैं तो मोस्ट वेलकम. सो इट रेजेस द क्वेश्चन, एट लास्ट वी विल डिस्कस दैट. इट रेजेस द क्वेश्चन, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ऑडियंस, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ म्यूजियम इज इंटेंड फॉर, डिफरेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन, डिफरेंट इश्यूज लाइक दैट. सो हिस्ट्री म्यूजियम्स, आर्ट म्यूजियम्स, साइंस सेंटर्स, चिल्ड्रंस म्यूजियम्स एंड लाइक दैट. So thank you, thanks a lot for being with us with this museum material culture. And just at last, I want to say happy Diwali to all of you. And very sorry for to take a little bit more time. And if you just can say about this, the question which I asked, is something changed here? Agar aap bata sakte hai, toh zarur bataiye. So most welcome. And thanks a lot to all of you again here. Just I will see here in chat box, is there any question? Okay. So abstract art, installation art, Rashmi, I agree. Yes, thank you. Thanks a lot, Rashmi ji. Yes, if there is any question, then now you can ask it. Before of that, if you just want to say a few lines about the which I was asked just now, if you want to say, then you can say, otherwise you can ask the question. Yes, please. Aparna ji, kuch puchna chahte hain?
Yes, I wanted to say about that picture you had shown. Yes. It was a kind of moving exhibition for rural kids where the charts were put on about the artifacts and the information was given in the school, so they could just this could have been like put anywhere and every kid or everybody can just come read about it and get information about it since they cannot reach the museums themselves.
Very true, and thanks a lot. And actually, in that exhibition, there is not a single artifact, but we use the canvas prints only there. But and in the last panel, we mentioned that if you want to know more, most welcome to visit our museum so that you will enjoy that museum with all the artifacts or whatever be there. So why we need this? Because such type of the exhibition which we can take with us anywhere and we use there and easily we can pick up this again we pack up that and we can move further. So ye humne develop kiya tha hamare own isme to 55 canvas prints hai wo only, but usko achhi tarah se design kiya and we get the benefit of that this exhibitions when we created one 22,000 square feet portable exhibition for US. हमने 22,000 square feet का एक exhibition जब US के जो Arizona sorry New Jersey Edison के लिए जब हमने बनाया था, तो उसके पीछे हमारा ये exhibition का 8 साल का अनुभव हमारे लिए फायदेमंद रहा. So just I want to say that we also learn from such type of the exhibitions. So yes, thank you. Anyone else? If there will be any question, most welcome. Otherwise, we will stop here now, and we'll meet again in our just one question. Agla session, hamara next Sunday rakhna hai kya? Will we continue our session on next Sunday, or you want to enjoy the Diwali? Please say. Please on your audio, or you just kept in. You write in chat box. With your permission, we will continue. Otherwise, we will skip it. And in next Sunday, we will continue.
Maybe sir, we can have a break, and okay. We can go for the following Sunday.
Yes,
thank you. We can have a break.
That's my opinion, but I respect.
Okay. Yes. Okay. We respect to all. Yes.
Yes, sir. Even I would request if there can be a break.
Yes. Okay. Yes, Rashmi ji, you want to say something?
Yeah, sir. Actually, today we got late. There are a lot of points which I have noted in today's lecture, and would really love to discuss that. and share some my knowledge also, but it's already late. Probably next session we can discuss this before we start a topic.
Definitely, definitely. And we need all the sessions, interactive sessions, not only one side, one way only. We need the interaction. Yes, most welcome.
Yes.
And yes, okay, with the respect of all these scholars and the participants, we will skip the next session on next Sunday. And then afterwards, we'll continue it in the, you can say after Diwali vacations. So once again, I wish you all a very happy Diwali. And
thank you, sir. Wish you the same.
Thank you.
Happy Diwali, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, most welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, most welcome, sir. Thank you.